My first battle of the morning. I know, I was gonna say, now it's a party. Well, glad that I'm here for a first stop. but no, I don't know, today, it's been a heavy week, so I'll probably just try and get through the movements a wee bit and keep myself moving. Come from something that's quite fast paced, so I've had to learn to slow myself down, which has been a challenge in itself, but I much prefer it, being able to slow it down and feel it a lot more rather than rushing through it and not really thinking about what I'm training or what I'm doing, just quick and move fast and faster. So it's, yeah, it's a nice change. I still do love elements of that though, of quick pace, fast.
Yep.
Just don't think about it, just move type. Yep. Some days I like to, you know, take it slow, and but yeah, it is nice to get in, get it done. So the morning works way better for me. Get to the gym, get it done before I can even think about it. I tried so hard to stick to a workout plan over a 4 to 5 week period, but I always find myself changing it or being like, oh, I could superset it with this and I could change that to that.
Is that because you didn't work out?
Pretty much, and when I'm waiting, I've had to get used to the feeling of you can leave the gym not feeling exhausted. You can leave feeling like you've moved but not ruin myself for the rest of the day. Yeah, by the time it's gotten to a point where I know what I'm coming in to do, I'm like, oh, you know, I like the wondering, which is nice. Because I wasn't sure if I would like the whole kind of coming in and doing my own thing, because I've been so used to group classes and training with a group of people all doing the same thing. I was like, oh, what if people look at me weird for doing, like, you know, clean and snatch and whatnot have you here. But no one bats an eye, which was great, because I thought it would be a bit like, what's she doing, you know? I've had to focus a lot on form too.
Yeah.
I came here, I saw one of the trainers for a while, Sinead, and then we were kind of like, whoa, the muscle's there, but the idea of it's not. So that's been really good. I try in the gym maybe 3-4 times just to incorporate some running stuff. Sometimes I'll come in and do sprints, which is nice, on the treadmill and just run in the morning. But yeah, I try to go for a nice long run on a Saturday. A hill run maybe somewhere after work sometime, if that happens. Usually I convince myself out of that one. But no, I don't know, running kind of came out of nowhere, I guess. When lockdown hit, I was in an apartment type building, so it was kind of like, can't go to the gym, what do? I need to do something. My mind's very active, likes to move. So I was like, oh, put my headphones in and go for a run. And I loved it. It was so great, I never thought I'd be a runner. Always hated cross country as a kid. Hated it with a passion. So to like find a love for it now was kind of weird. So I ran my first marathon last year, which was pretty random. I got home after a night out, after a few drinks and hearing people talk about running marathons and things, and I thought, all right, let's just sign up, make myself do it, make myself run. So yeah, went to pay for the half, Queenstown Marathon. I thought, nah, bugger it. We'll just go for the full, see what happens. Worst case, I can pull out. I was talking to Ben about it around the gym, and he was like, oh, have you done one before? No. Done much running? Not really. He's kind of like, what are you doing? So he helped me out with a bit of running stuff, which was amazingly helpful because my body was so used to strength training and like very kind of static movements, lifting heavy weights. So running was a bit to get used to, kind of using things one at a time with running, training my legs individually really helped. And he gave me some good stretches and yeah, no, after that I was off. I was off really. Just out of high school, I think it was. I grew up quite a bit playing football with my brothers and just played for a club, played throughout high school and things. And then when I finished high school, obviously I couldn't play for them anymore, so I was like, what next? Just kind of wanted something that focused a bit more on just what I wanted to do. I did love the team sport and I'm definitely thinking of getting back into it. Just now that I've got Saturdays and stuff free, it's awesome. But yeah, it would have been around then that I started getting into it through study and stuff. No, it was cool. So quite a long time in and out of CrossFit gym, yeah. Did a couple of the kind of local competitions and then my love for it just kind of grew and grew and I kind of just felt myself getting stronger and fitter and no, it was awesome. So cool. Just challenge to myself, keep me interested. I met an awesome group of girls who I still train with today. And we all just kind of like putting ourselves through the hurt locker together. I guess it's just so much better doing it in a group. I just kind of use an app, just log in kind of what I want to do. My partner's pretty keen on the gym himself, knows how chaotic I am. I was like, oh, can you just do me a plan that kind of just would fit with running, that I can keep my strength up, keep my running going. So it's pretty kind of like, I'll do legs, back, arms in one day, but I love it. So much easier. I could be like, oh, I hated that, or that was heavy. Works really well, actually. I've had to try and learn
how to train my body for running. I guess the strength, it's so different running than doing weightlifting stuff. So just doing different things like single-legged stuff has been really good. Just training, yeah. I like how I can focus on one part of my body and just kind of work on that, strengthen that, and just kind of slow it down, I guess. Which is really cool.
Have you been getting a program from Partner Fruits?
Even better, right?
That's the perks.
Yeah.
That's why you're with them.
Right? Don't expose me. I guess it is to just kind of get into multi-sport and see where it can take me. I kind of just like how I can run and see so much more than you could if I was to drive, or, you know. It's just nice, I can just do it on my own time, put my headphones in, fill my vest with snacks and just go and see where I want to end up. Especially going on holiday and things, it's nice just to go for a wee jog and just look around. You see so much more. So just keep going as long as I enjoy it, really. Yeah, it's quite a cool running community out there, I guess, and I've got to meet some cool people and run with them, and no, it's nice. Nice change for me. Yeah, I really do just train for myself. I guess as cheesy as it sounds, I just feel so much better afterwards. It's cliche as probably working out gets, really, but no, I don't know. If I put too much pressure on myself, I sometimes can feel that I start to, you know, beat myself up a bit more if I don't get a lift or if I don't feel strong or whatever, but if I just take a relaxed attitude towards it, it's a lot more like enjoyable, I guess. Because that's, I just love it. I start moving, doing stuff. Just been feeling strong day to day. So I just really do it for that. But yeah, like I've competed in the past in group aspects, and yeah, it is a lot of fun, and the atmosphere is always great, and everyone's always so supportive. So yeah, I definitely am not opposed to getting back into it. But at the moment, like with work and stuff, it's just nice, just complements it really well. Just being able to get a good balance of both. But once I get work under control a wee bit, up my confidence there, then maybe I'll focus on the gym a bit more. But yeah, at the moment, it's just kind of find a good balance between everything I want to do and squish it all into a day. The days go by so fast. Being able to fit in, going for a bike ride on the weekend and getting a run in and going for, you know, doing some gym stuff, seeing people, doing other things. It's, yeah, it's not much time in the day. I was just trying to squeeze in like strength training, running training. I was still kind of working out how to mix them both together. But yeah, it definitely made me realize the importance of rest and just taking a day off, just going for a walk or doing something a little lower impact. Because I really burnt myself out doing that. But it is hard when the mind's willing, but the body just isn't, I think. So I definitely learned the value of listening to my body a bit more and, yeah, just kind of giving myself a bit of a break. But I think now I found a good kind of rhythm into getting my runs and training for that, keeping, like, doing my strength stuff, keeping my toes in the CrossFit side of things, especially here it's kind of like a little hybrid type gym for that kind of thing. I do kind of want to go back to it. Some days I'm like really torn to go back and give it another good go, but yeah, shift's too hard to get everything balanced, I guess. I miss the CrossFit side, the gymnastics side of it, and kind of climbing on the ropes or, you know, getting my feet to bar and bar muscle ups and things like that. I got into a real good rhythm of it and then kind of mixed it up again, but it's still there, so I might get back to it one stage, I think. Good.
Ready for the day?
Yeah, ready for the day.